Hello everyone, welcome back to Slides to Coasters Podcast, your source for anything and everything theme park, water park, and holiday related. My name, of course, is Brad the Water Parker. I am your host for this most fantastic show, joined once again by my very good friend, Ethan. Ethan, say hey.
Hello guys, glad to be back on Slides to Coasters. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so if you guys don't know already, Ethan and I have been breaking down top five things per area at Kings Island. This is a monthly series we've been doing. And today we're going to be talking about Coney Mall. Now, if you guys don't know already, Coney Mall is one of those parts of the park where we've seen a lot of investment very recently. We've seen the Coney Mall, Coney Barbecue. We've seen the antique cars. We've seen renovations all around the area for theming and just general upgrades. And Ethan, as you know, this is a very large point of contention right now, you know, with everyone talking about Kings Island, because we just lost Vortex. We still have this Action Zone Theater that's still used for Haunt, mind you. But there's a lot of areas of this side of the park that have a lot of potential. And Ethan and I are going to break down our top five things we'd like to see come out to Coney Mall. Which, Ethan, I think that you should start, because I started before. I think that you should start this time.
All right, well, thanks for throwing it off to me for the first one. So my number five recommendation for what I would like to see Kings Island do with the Coney Mall area starts with what started Kings Island in the first place, and that would be the Razor roller coaster we have known to love and appreciate. Now, don't worry, I am not saying anything, change Racer, no. It's still going to be the Racer that we know and love. My renovation of the Racer goes into two aspects, and the first one is going to be just a simple retrack, which they've been doing, you know. Same layout, just kind of keeping the place in the wood, and at this scale, they would do it a little bit larger than they have before. I know in 2020 off-season, I think it was 500 feet of wood track that they did to renovate it, and for my renovation scale, it would just kind of take care of the rest of it, and any rough patches of the ride at the bottom of the base of the hills, retract them, any rough turns, rough laterals, get some extra support to that, just for this renovation, make it as smooth as possible. And for my second part of my renovation for Racer would be bringing back the classic red, white, and blue color scheme that we saw when Kings Island opened up in the early 70s. This would consist of the track being mostly the white part, and then the rails on the side for, I'm not getting the word right, but on the sides of the track, so the red and blue. This kind of overall would help the area kind of fill in, get that Coney Mall festive color scheme going, make it feel more like a carnival, an arcade, that fair style that they were mimicking for opening. This would go back once again to Kings Island roots, which they love to do, and I think this is definitely a feasible possibility for Kings Island to implement in the future.
Yeah, and you know, talking about Racer here for a second, they are doing a lot more track work this offseason. They actually recently had a blog to where they're doing a lot more track work on, I believe, the back part again, so they're working their way back up to make it more smooth. And Ethan, I will say it time and time again, I will ride Racer once or twice a year, you know, but it's not my favorite wooden coaster at the park. And I think that, you know, going off of your track work deal, why don't we add back that old little dip right before the brake run? We had that once before. I think we could do it again. You know, maybe bring in someone like GCI to come on in, maybe reprofile, do that dip. I think that would be very cool and very nice for the park in general, as the Racer, I do not believe, should be RMC'd. I was actually originally thinking about coming in and saying, yeah, RMC to Racer. No, I'm not going to say that. I don't believe in it. I do believe RMC come in with some topper track maybe in the future. I'm not opposed to that. I know a lot of people are wooden coaster purists. I know there are individual like that out there right now. I'm not one of them. I believe that if you have an amazing coaster, if you have a coaster of this magnitude, of this legacy, you need to go and take care of it. And part of taking care of it is maybe adding some extra support, extra fluff, and sections that it desperately needs. So Ethan, I think that that would be a spectacular thing to do for our first part of changing up Coney Mall. Going on to number four here, we're going to talk about Action Theater. So if you guys don't know, the Action Theater was back next. So if you're riding Racer, actually, and if you're on Windseeker, if you see that big giant building in between the Racer, that's Action Theater. Currently, it is being used for Haunt, Ethan. It's being used for one of my favorite haunts, actually, Urden Scare. I love that haunt. I love the theme. I love everything about it. So, me for myself personally, and I know that you have some contradicting theories about this, but I would love for Action Theater to be removed and maybe add a classic Wild Mouse or a classic Steel Coaster to that area. Maybe buy an old Galaxy, remodel, refresh, just put in something that's classic, that is fun for the whole entire family. Because Ethan, I'm gonna be real, it's practically a ghost town once you get down to Windseeker. You know, it just kind of feels weird, it feels off, it doesn't feel right. I feel like it should flow. And I think that if we were to add something like a Wild Mouse or a classic Steel Coaster, that would really bring a lot of foot traffic back towards Windseeker again. Maybe even widening up that path to go into that area. I know that you have some opinions that aren't similar to mine. So, Ethan, I'm going to let you pick it up from here.
Yeah, and Brad, you know, I don't think that everything you're saying, I definitely do see some points that you're saying. For example, down by Vortex, where Vortex's exit was in Windseeker, it is pretty much a ghost town, excluding maybe when Haunt is, you have a little bit more foot traffic, but no one has a reason to really go down that pathway. Now, my vision for what Action Theater would do, it's a little bit different. I would like to see them maintain that building. You know, it has been there since I think it was the 90s that it was built. It's Kingsland already constructed, and I feel like that structurally it's fine, and they can kind of repurpose it for something else. So I would see to say that maybe like a little bit of renovation on the outside, making it look a little bit more modern. And I would probably go along the route of gutting the center of it out. As you know, before it was used for Days of Thunder in the 90s, and also a SpongeBob attraction, I know, and a Dinosaurs Alive using that 4D technology, which nowadays, you know, this was a big commodity in the late 90s, early 2000s, but for nowadays, it's not really too sought out for, not really something that's too unique. So I feel like just kind of gutting that out, making the haunt, that can also go, unfortunately, for me and my plans. But I would love to see that building be repurposed for some sort of new show, because in this area of the park, there aren't really any shows at Kings Island as of now. We have the Kings Island Theater, and also the Fest House has a few shows in it. And in that part of the park over by Coney Mall, there isn't really many shows in that area, and drawing some shows would draw some attention to that. I could also see another route where they could were able to put a flat ride, like kind of you're saying. You know, I know that they would have to probably expand out the building a little bit if doing so, and that could be a little bit pricey, but heck, they could put a flat ride. Even if we could combine both of our ideas, you know, Dark Knight Coaster at the Six Flags Parks, they have the Wild Mouse model inside the building. That just makes it so much more better and exciting and fun, and that has good reviews. But I do agree with Brad that unfortunately this area does get low foot traffic, not really popular. I have more of a vision to keep it there, just kind of repurpose the building. But overall, it would be really exciting to see Kings Island do something great with that part of the park.
Yeah, and just bouncing off, because I just thought about this, so I didn't even talk about it in our pre-show. Ethan and I do a pre-show, by the way. We actually talk about these topics, and we spent the past like 15, 20 minutes talking about it. Down at Carowinds, did you ride the Plants vs. Zombies attraction?
I did ride it. I think it was in 2018 was my last visit where I got to ride it.
I know that for myself, I didn't get to ride. How would you feel if Cedar Fair continued that and put that in where Action Theater is currently?
I think that it wouldn't necessarily be the worst idea. I feel like they could probably do a different theme, kind of like how they were doing it. California's Great America, kind of changing it now. I just feel like that running that risk potentially years on, the attendance for that would go down. I can already see reports of people who go to Carowinds where Plants vs. Zombies is, you know, getting very low attendance rooms. And, you know, of course, with Plants vs. Zombies, you want as many people as possible. And I feel like they're kind of setting themselves up for failure in the future with that possible thing. But if they could kind of compromise together, get a theme going on that would be able to support low attendance numbers, high attendance numbers, and allow people 10 years from now to bring something, you know, bring more attention, gather attention still 10 years from now, then I feel like that would be a great success.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So let's move on to number three, because I know that we've been talking about this for a while, and we both hate this, if I understand correctly. So why don't you take it from here, Ethan?
All right, so yes, the area we're going to be focusing on is a little bit closer to Rivertown, but it is still technically Coney Mall. Part of their kind of arcade-style games that they have along the midway, they have these basketball shooter things where you'd shoot probably free throw distance across. If you make it, you get a basketball. Well, they recently constructed one over by towards where the Beast is, technically, where you would walk back towards the Beast. And there's also one over by the Coca-Cola refreshment station, kind of facing towards back lot. There's also one over towards the Racer in that area. So they have three in this area that, when I go by, there's only certain ones that get certain attentions. And this one over by Beast gains our attention because the whole platform that you're standing on when you're shooting these free throws is slanted at an angle. So it's like, compared to all these other ones, why would you want to shoot at one that is at a certain angle? And that would seem like you'd get a disadvantage to that. So we feel like, even though that I just constructed a little bit recently, that we don't really like the idea of this one. We feel like it could be torn out. It's pointless. It's the one that has nobody ever shooting at it. And we feel like that Coney Mall could use a great new flat ride. There are many great possibilities. You look at Carowinds, what they've added with their county fair. We see Cannon's Wonderland adding these thrilling flat rides, especially the Lumberjack one that they have over at Cannon's Wonderland. It looks exciting. There are great possibilities, but I can not name one better possibility of a flat ride to go in that spot than a Mondial Top Scan.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. This guy and his freaking Top Scans. You're committing heresy right now.
Heresy, really?
Yeah. You know why? This is a place of, like, if there's a holy spot in Kings Island, right? Like, if there is a place where you should have a moment of silence, there are few places in Kings Island where you need to do this, but right here is the reason why I say that you are committing sacrilege and heresy, because this is where the original Flying Eagles used to be. The Flying Scooters. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we did get a Flying Scooters at Woodstock Gliders over at Planet Snoopy. But who cares about that if I don't want to go on in there as a grown adult and be around little kids? I don't want to be that random dude. I mean, it's like, I know there's coaster enthusiasts who actually go on back there who still ride, and more power to you. But, Ethan, I would love to see the Flying Scooters return to this location. I think that we have a prime spot. I think it's part of Kings Island's legacy, as we were talking about before. They like doing stuff like this, and I think this is a perfect opportunity for the park to go on ahead and bring back something that's classic, bring back some, retro theming. Heck, you're talking about the other locations. We've got, three or four of these places around the park?
Mm-hmm.
Like, come on, you have one that's more further, it just gets to the point, for myself at least, to where enough's enough. We have enough. I don't want any more. It's just like, I don't care for them to begin with. We've already got two other ones in Coney Mall. It's just like, how many basketball shoot 'em ups do you need? You could take this out and put it at the other location right next to the other Sprite shootout thing. I don't know what they call it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really care because it blares loud music that disrupts my whole entire theming of the park. No offense. And I love I have to admit, I feel for our games employees at Kings Island. I feel for you. I do. I feel for you. I feel for you every day. But I'm sorry. This is a spot that should have been taken out a long time ago. That should have never happened. We should have kept the Flying Eagles because you could keep them there because Backlot Sun Coaster didn't even touch it. Put back in the Flying Eagles. Keep Woodstock Gliders. Or move it. I don't care. Put in the gliders right here. It's the prime location. It's exactly where home's supposed to be, Ethan. And I think that go ahead, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, so I actually had one more point to add to that that I just remembered, because I went down to Dollywood a few weeks ago, and I noticed that they also have one of those three-point basketball shootout games, and guess what they were doing with that, Brad? They were not using it for a three-point basketball shootout. They were using it for a mask-off area. They put benches inside the basketball court. They had nets around it just so it could, you know, be contained as a mask area. Obviously, that's sending me a message that's not really beneficial as much of a moneymaker in that park that only has one, mind you, one.
You know what?
Three-point basketball shootout.
Good on Dollywood. Good on Dollywood. They know how crappy that attraction is. They know that they shouldn't even have one. So they just got on the head and said, you know what? Relax here. That's what I want to see. Dollywood, I love you so much. You are one of my favorite. That is music to my ears, Ethan. Music to my very loving Flying Scooters ears. Okay. Sorry, I kind of went on a rant there for a minute. I'm very, very open about my feelings about basketball games at the parks. Yeah, you don't want to get hit with one. Anyways, going on number two, this is something that Ethan brought up, and you know, originally Ethan was going to talk about this one, but you know what? Ethan, do you want to talk about this one? Because you brought this one up. And I'll talk about number one.
For sure. So, my number two renovation, I actually got inspiration from, you know, doing some investigation myself on what would be good in this area. Because there is a video, I want to give credit to Christian Cook for this video. He put a video on YouTube, kind of a model of what he would want to see for Coney Mall doing, and I want to steal one of his ideas right here, but there's this credit to him. That's where I got my inspiration from. He has a sky ride going from the very most left-hand part of Coney Mall, stretching all the way down to that Windseeker, kind of where Vortex and Antique Cars Plaza was. And I think that is a brilliant idea. It really gives me vibes back to Cedar Point, what they're doing with their Midway, where it goes all the way up the Midway, goes down. And that sky ride does get a lot of attendance for it, and I feel like that even though many sky rides aren't being put in at parks, I feel like that definitely modern sky ride models are out there where you don't have to worry too much about maintenance, about breaking down. I feel like it would do a great fit, and you know, it could help encourage more people who really don't want to go to the back of the park because they don't really like walking around as much to be able to take advantage of that sky ride and still feel like they're getting in everything that's in that area. And I feel like it would fit beautifully. It would still be a little bit of a momentum to the past of the park. I know we brought it up in our previous discussion that we had before, which honestly could go in one of those two spots, a former location it used to be in, or this new prototype example in Coney Mall. But it seems very exciting, and I love seeing it in that video, and I just have to mention it to be a possible future addition for Coney Mall. Brad, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, the only problem with this addition is the fact that it would have to end near Windseeker. That's the only issue with that installation. However, I think they can do it. I think they can do it. And you know, Ethan, my grandmother cannot walk Kings Island. And I said this before when we were talking about Oktoberfest. My grandmother can't walk Kings Island. My father has a hard time walking around Kings Island. But if we're to add a sky ride again, let's take out that stupid freaking basketball game.
Preach, brother.
Let's like, you know, we'll take out that little storage area, take out the basketball game, have it go up and down, you know, have it go all the way down and make it curve a little bit. And heck, you could even have it stop where Vortex once was, you know, like, I don't really care. Let's create something that is fun for everyone. And that we could all go and ride and have a great time on. And I think that something like a sky ride is perfect for that side of the park. I think that is classic. I think it gives the park flavor. It gives the park a little bit. And again, if you have two sky rides, you know, that would be really nice. That would be really cool. It's just like, again, Ethan, these are not far out, you know, ideas to put in. this is like, you know, maybe an off year. You know, this is like, of course, you got 5-year plans with King's Island. We know they have 5-year plans, King's Island, because Mike Koontz, he actually talked about the fact that there's a 5-year plan out of Coaster Stock. So it's kind of like for myself, I see where the direction where Koontz is taking us with bringing back, and again, this is a guy who's really, and again, I gotta give him kudos. This guy knows his park. This guy knows his clientele. He is an amazing dude. I love the additions that he's put in. I love the antique autos. I love every single thing that he's checked marked. Orion, well, you know, I might disagree on it here and there, but it's still a very fun attraction. And I think that in general, this little idea of putting in a sky ride could be coupled with doing something like a Flying Scooters or a Top Scan. This could be coupled with a Racer lift up. You know, these are things that could happen all at once. You know, this could be like a very, very good year for Kings Island if they do it right. So I think that we definitely got something good going there, Ethan, but our last one is something that has become a red herring for the coaster enthusiast community for the past several years now. It's been the past 2 years. Well, actually, for the past year, technically. Sorry. I'm thinking of 2021 because I've been writing 2021 for my calendar. Vortex. Ethan, we both have a piece of Vortex sitting in our rooms, either in our office or our room. I got in my office right behind me, actually. I don't know where you have your piece of Vortex, but we both have this very beautiful piece of aero machinery. And this is a huge plot that has been left for Vortex. And we're going to spend the rest of the show kind of breaking down coaster types. And I know we're up 21 minutes. We're going to spend the rest of our show, whether it turns into 45 or even an hour, talking about what 5 coasters we could add in to this location. Because Ethan and I both talked, and I'm going to go through one, then Ethan's going to go through one, and we're going to end off with something I like. But basically, we've got 5 coasters here that we're really excited for, and I think the first one that we got to talk about, Ethan, is a B&M Dive. We already got one up at Cedar Point. I know that a lot of people, you know, the one the Vaudavan is a very interesting coaster because a lot of people give it flack because we already have 2 dive coasters that are really well themed down in BGT and over at BGW, Griffin and Sheikra, respectively. So you have these 2 coasters that are really nicely themed, but Vaudavan really didn't do that. It was more about being in the air. And I think that, Ethan, we could have that come back with a coaster that would be a dive coaster. It maybe comes on up, curves around the same deck deal as Vortex, actually. You go into this little ravine, come back out, you know, go around. You could do a lot of cool things this plot of land, Ethan. But I know that a lot of people are kind of worried they'll take away from the beast. I don't think that it will. I think that you can add something with maybe even a tunnel element that would really work. You know, you could put in a classic name like the Comet, or you know, you could put in something like Wildcat even, because those are kind of names that would be reminiscent of an, you know, time before King's Island. But Ethan, I understand that you have something else you'd like to talk about, another coaster style.
Yeah, and keeping in the theme of dive coaster, one of the other talked about manufacturers for this potential coaster coming in that Vortex plot is Gerstlauer. And Gerstlauer has recently put out, as we've seen with Cedar Fair putting out with Knott's Berry Farm, their Gerstlauer dive coaster. Now, this is kind of the same type of Gerstlauer track we're all familiar with. It has feeds that are 4x4, 16 people per ride, so a little bit different looking than that traditional B&M dive coaster we see. But with Hangtime being put in, it was put in at Boomerang's plot at Knott's Berry Farm, if you're familiar with that. It's a little bit more compacter, but it has such a beautiful light package that it my first time seeing it, I thought of what possibly Coney Mall could do with some sort of light package. And I feel like carrying along that theme, with Vortex, we did lose a traditional looping roller coaster, that big multi-launch roller, not multi-launch, multi-looping roller coaster. Besides that, we pretty much only have Banshee, which is an invert covering that. So I feel like Kings Island would really benefit with some sort of multi-inversion type roller coaster. And I can't think of one of the better types than a Gyroslava dive coaster. Could feature things like five inversions or so. Could be a little bit more spread out than it is at Knott's Berry Farm. But having that light package light up in Knott's Berry Farm or Vortex's plot would be such a photogenic opportunity. Just how his Vortex was at nighttime with going the lights going up the lift. This would be such a huge staple where everyone would want to go at night, take pictures of this new attraction at Coney Mall, and it would be such a great opportunity for the park. And overall, Gerstlauer has gotten great reviews with hang time over at Knott's Berry Farm. It's been glossy smooth from reports coming out. It has a little bit of a different dive element, but it is still a great attraction for the general public to go out and see. And that is a potential pick going for the Vortex plot at Kings Island. And I believe, Brad, you have another one.
Yeah,
That's a very
so
creative idea.
you know, Gershlauer, again, Gershlauer Dive is actually a pretty good idea. I love the Gershlauer Dive at Hangtime. But essentially
Essentially
for
for
myself
myself
as
as well,
well, why don't we just put in what we lost? Let's
let's
put
put
in
in
a
a Vekoma
Vekoma sit-down
sit-down
thrill
thrill
coaster.
coaster.
The
The
Vekoma
Vekoma
sit-down
sit-down
thrill
thrill
coaster
coaster
is
is
actually
actually
almost
almost
to
to
a
a
T
T
a
a
photocopy.
photocopy.
If
If
you
you
go
go
and
and
look
look
on
on
their
their
website,
website,
it
it
looks
looks
like
like
a
a
photocopy
photocopy
of
of
what
what
we
we
originally
originally
had
had
with
with
Vortex.
Vortex.
Vekoma,
Vekoma,
I
I
understand,
understand,
it's
it's
a
a
brand
brand
that
that
Cedar
Cedar
Fair
Fair
doesn't
doesn't
like
like
working
working
with
with
just
just
because
because
of
of
the
the
issues
issues
that
that
they've
they've
had
had
before.
before.
But
But
when
when
you
you
go
go
and
and
sit
sit
down
down
and
and
when
when
you
you
look
look
at
at
this
this
on
on
paper,
paper,
this
this
is
is
the
the
exact
exact
same
same
attraction.
attraction.
You
You
know,
know,
this
this
is
is
the
the
exact
exact
kind
kind
of
of
format.
format.
This
This
looks
looks
like
like
the
the
same
same
exact
exact
track
track
style.
style.
You know, I think that they
They
could
could
do
do
something
something
with
with
this.
this.
I
I
think
think
they
they
can
can
make
make
a
a
quality
quality
attraction.
attraction.
And
And
if
if
not
not
same,
same,
it's
it's
similar.
similar.
But
But
I
I
think
think
they
they
could
could
definitely
definitely
do
do
something
something
here
here
with
with
a
a
Vekoma
Vekoma
because
because
this
this
would
would
be
be
a,
a,
essentially
essentially
a
a
word
word
for
for
word
word
remake.
remake.
Will
Will
be
be
a
a
change,
change,
you
you
know.
know.
Of
Of
course,
course,
there
there
becomes
becomes
the
the
issue
issue
of,
of,
well,
well,
Vekoma,
Vekoma,
does
does
it
it
have
have
the
the
reliability?
reliability?
Well,
Well,
it's
it's
owned
owned
by
by
SNS
SNS
now,
now,
and
and
SNS
SNS
is
is
amazing
amazing
reliability.
reliability.
I
I
love
love
the
the
SNS
SNS
coasters.
coasters.
So,
So,
I
I
think
think
in
in
general,
general,
we've
we've
got
got
a
a
coaster
coaster
company
company
that
that
can
can
create
create
something
something
similar.
similar.
Why
Why
don't
don't
we
we
just
just
recreate
recreate
the
the
Vortex?
Vortex?
Because
Because
Vortex,
Vortex,
Ethan,
Ethan,
I
I
know
know
that
that
you
you
and
and
I
I
both
both
agree,
agree,
Vortex
Vortex
was
was
a
a
really
really
nice
nice
coaster.
coaster.
It was a really good
Yes.
coaster. If it did not have the rickety and rough as what, you know, 30, 20 plus years of ridership would do, you know, if you were to have that same exact coaster come back, that would be a very nice reminisce, very nice callback. Because a lot of people miss that coaster. I miss that coaster even. So I think that the next coaster on our list is something that you've been wanting for a hot minute. We talked about in our Oktoberfest video.
Yeah, and my next addition manufacturer would be from Mach. And just like Gerstlauer, this is also off of past trends that Cedar Fair has done. We've seen Knott's Berry Farm add Gerstlauer over at Carowinds with Cockpride Strike. That's where we got our first Mach multi-launch roller coaster. And I've tend to notice that with Cedar Fair, they do like to keep the same batch of manufacturers, add the same types of roller coaster types, especially at their flagship parks. And this has been a hot rumor that several people have shared of adding a mock multi-launch roller coaster. It would consist of several things that we lost with Vortex, the multiple inversions. It would add kind of a new little twist with the launches, multi-launch. I don't think backlot counts as multi-launch, so it'll be pretty much a more true multi-launch. I could even have three. That would be a record for Kings Island. And overall, you know, Cockpride Strike's a little bit more compact. It's more out and back. With the Vortex plot land, it has a wider plot, so you could either capitalize and use a whole huge strip of it, or you could kind of even use like half of it and also use the other kind of more the area closer to the pathway as more of a flat ride kind of package too, if you want to add a big whole bunch to it. But I feel like a mock multi-launch definitely has a good chance of being added. It fits well, it continues along with the company's trend, and I believe that the general public would love the idea of having another launch roller coaster and an inverted launch coaster coming to the park out in the open. It would be very photogenic. You could do some stuff with light packages, and overall it would be a great addition to Kings Island if they went through with it.
Yeah, and you know, kind of rounding out our five coasters here, RMC. I know that you were not a huge fan of this, but I'm going to put out two RMCs, two different styles of RMC, because I think they could both work here. An iBox track hybrid, which would be something similar like, you know, of course, not going to be as big, but something similar like Steel Vengeance, you know, maybe even something more akin with Iron Rattler. I think that size and that length could be attained here. Of course, you could call it Revenge of the Beast, you know, and you could have Son of Beast again, which would be perfect because it's right next to the Beast. You know, I always heard the gripe, well, Son of Beast isn't next to the Beast, so why is it Son of Beast? Well, Son of Beast could be right next to the Beast now. So you have this potential here of adding in a, you know, either iBox or Topper Track. Again, I know that we just added a wooden coaster very recently, but if you're to add a Topper Track, you know, Goliath, and Lightning Rod, and Outlaw Run even, they all get spectacular reviews. And of course, if not one of those, you could add something like a Raptor, you know, an RMC Raptor or an RMC T-Rex when those come. You know, Ethan, this is all about a company that has time and time again proved reliability, except for Lightning Rod, which that's just tearing itself apart, which is understandable. But, you know, you've got this company that creates amazing coasters. You got coasters like Wicked Cyclone, Storm Chaser, Iron Rattler, New Texas Giant, Twisted Timbers, Steel Vengeance, of whom the only coaster that's ground up is Steel Vengeance on this list, if I remember correctly. So, you know, ground up RMC, that would be something that, again, has been done before in Cedar Fair's history. I think that we can do something like a ground up RMC, iBox, Topper Track, or Raptor even. We have a lot of great space here. I think that we have a lot of great ways to go and create a coaster that kind of stands out in the skyline again, because Kings Island's missing it. I'm sorry, but that little patch, it just feels void. You know, of course, Orion kind of took that a little bit, but at the end of the day, I miss seeing Vortex. I miss seeing something in Vortex's spot, so whatever we get, I'm hoping that we can get something that's semi-tall, something around 165, maybe 200. I don't really know. Personally, I like to keep it at 165, get that 180-foot drop. So with that being said, Ethan, we kind of ran through five different styles of coasters here. What's your number one pick for all five?
Now, my number one pick, I would have to go with the Gerstlauer Dive Coaster, just because of the fact that it carries those inversions back, having a sit-down layout, has a crowd-pleaser element with the dive drop, and with that light package, I feel like, based on the positive reviews I've gotten from Knott's Berry Farm, that Kings Island would definitely benefit. You know, Knott's Berry Farms is a very busy park, has similar numbers, if not more, to Kings Island, and they can hold it down with that capacity-wise. I feel like Cedar Fair is looking at that success of that and picturing something like Hang Time right in that spot of Vortex.
Yeah, and you know, for myself, I think that I'm going to put a name down because just looking at this, I think it's kind of best for me to just say something. I think that if they were to add something like a Bermuda Blitz sit-down coaster, that would be the design that would be to go for myself personally. This is something that over in Poland, they have a Bermuda Blitz. I forget the name. Try to think of it. It's basically essentially, they only have one, if I remember correctly. It's Lek Coaster at a Legendia Slashki Wesoli Miasko. I'm sorry, if you're from Poland, I completely botched your name, but Lek Coaster is one of those coasters that a lot of people love. I've heard nothing but good things, and I think that would be something, if you were to make even a clone, that would be perfect for this location. So, I know a lot of people don't like the fact that I'm going for the coma here. I really didn't think about it myself, but just now started thinking about it. I think that it's different. I think that it's new. I think it's something that's fresh. I think it's something that Kings Island would definitely enjoy. I think that the guests at Kings Island would enjoy. But with that being said, Ethan, do you have any final comments about our top five things for Coney Mall?
Well, absolutely. There is a lot that Kings Island could do with this area, but it is important to remember it is great on its own how it is right now. But it does have a lot of potential in the future. Kings Island has a lot of great things to work with, and how they've been alluding to their past with new attractions and new additions. It's been great and fantastic for our perspective, and I feel like definitely that this Vortex plot of land is going to be filled up again in the next 5 years or so within that time frame. And I am confident that whatever Kings Island adds, it's going to be a crowd pleaser, it's going to look great, and it's going to carry on that photogenic nature that Vortex had before.
Yeah, definitely. And just kind of bouncing off that, Kings Island already has an amazing area with Coney Mall. I love walking down it. It's one of those parts of the parks where you just walk up and down all day and really not have a headache, except for the basketball games, which I will say no to all the time. But they have something really good going with this part of the park. And I'm really looking forward to in the future when we see much more expansion, when we see a lot more refreshment. There is a lot to work with in this part of the park. There is a lot of cool things we can do. But at the same time, Kings Island has to grow one way or another. And I think that we're going to start getting to the points where we're going to see some of the things we're talking about here come out. We're going to see maybe an addition of a flat ride to where the Sprite Shootout is, racer lift up. We're coming up to an anniversary year, so we might be able to see that. I don't know. But with that being said, guys, what are your thoughts about what we talked about here today? I know this is a little bit longer than usual. We try to keep it around 30 minutes, but we're at 37, so that's all right. Tell us what you guys think down below. Of course, if you haven't already, go check out our Discord, go check out Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. We're gonna be posting a lot more on our Instagram. I keep on saying that. I just never get around. I haven't been able to get around to it just because school and work and everything in between. So with that being said, for myself and Ethan, stay tropical, have a Merry Christmas, and we'll see you guys in the next one.